Hello everybody, this is BTS Pro, and today I'm going to be drawing Mushu from Mulan. So let's go ahead and get started, and let's see what we get. I'm going to start off with, of course, a ball. About yay big. And what I'm going to do here first is I'm going to lay in some really big basic shapes. So what we're going to do is we're going to come off and we're going to lay in a cross line right there. And that this shape will become kind of evident later on. But what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and rough in Mushu's muzzle. But we need to also add one more cross line, crosshair about right there, construction line, whatever you want to call it. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to come in right here. We're going to come out and kind of do... It's this really big shape. And that's going to be where we're going to put Mushu's nose and his mouth. This is basically his mouth. So, all right, now let's come in here and we're going to go back and work on his eyes. But since we're in this part, we're going to go ahead and work on Mushu's nose. And Mushu's nose is kind of a... shaped like maybe an almond. And then what we're going to do is come back here, right where this point is right there, right where these two points meet. We're going to go ahead and draw in just these big circles. They're more like ovals. Okay. And then Mushu, we're in doing a 3/4 view. So we're going to come down just a little bit off of the top, maybe 3/4 inch. And we're going to come out and we're going to come right to this line. Just like that. And then we're going to go ahead and rough in his like a little cheekbone right here. Right under his eye. Bringing it back to this main construction line. And don't worry about if things overlap. It helps give a sense of depth. Let's go ahead, since we're working on his eyes, let's go ahead and give a little bit more definition to him. And remember to keep your lines flowing. I'm going to go ahead and do the detail under his eye too. And this of course will be a little bit clearer and clean up. And Mushu has this big eye lid. It kind of comes up, just a big arch. Goes right back down. Alright, and he also has this other. Tell you what, let's bring that over just a little bit more. Alright, now we have this other eyebrow, it's kind of poking out it right there. And this picture of Mushu is actually coming right out of the movie. And this kind of little, this part of the ball right here, just kind of darken it in, because that can be part of his, part of his back of his head or whatever. So, alright, now let's go ahead and tell you what, let's draw in some of Mushu's. I guess they would be scales, since he's a dragon and not a lizard. We're going to make this little curve that comes down. It's going to connect back into this jawline because Mushu is smiling. We'll come off this part of his mouth. We'll come around and kind of come close to here. Now this is the bottom part. Or I should say this is his lip line, and this is going to be where his teeth is going to end up being, because we're going to kind of draw, because this is kind of where it's going to end, and we're going to kind of come up this way. I'll tell you what, let's go ahead and add in his teeth and we'll clarify it in a little bit more detail since we're down here. Lip comes around, classic Disney lip, and I'm going to do a really rough shape, just kind of following the lines that I'm looking for. Bring it back into there. Just remember, whenever you're drawing, start off with basic shapes and then you can clarify. Like, let's go ahead and I'm going to put him in these little markings. Now, Mushu also has horns, So, and they're just, they're very similar to these things, the whisker part right here. So in shading, you kind of have to denote them a little bit different. In fact, if you want to exaggerate them a little bit, you can, but don't do it too much. And sometimes you'll have to play, because the actual drawing, the picture I'm looking at of Mushu, there's like a little tangent that gets created between these two guys right there. Coming off in this area, let's just draw a small circle. That's going to kind of help us with his whisker. We're going to come off that, and we're just going to kind of come down and out. And it's the same way on the bottom. I'm just going to kind of freeform it a little bit. Mushu also has some ears. And there's just a lot of lines right in this area. I mean, but I'm going to kind of cheat a little bit. Mushu's ear is not this high up, but I want to break all these little tangents that are very strong in this drawing. And Mushu's ear kind of comes out, and it's kind of shaped like a potato chip. And Mushu has this little divot out of his ear, kind of like Stitch has. And of course, you got to draw in the top of his ear. And Mushu also has, I almost left it out. Stupid of me. Mushu has this little wrinkle. It goes right behind his nose. It just comes up and goes down. And then it overlaps and then does that right there. Mushu's nose, you know, it's very stylized. And believe it or not, it has a little curve there. And it comes around since we are in three-quarter view. And then it just kind of dies off right there. So it's just a classic S-shaped nose. Let's now go ahead and draw in Mushu's neck. And it's just going to connect, you know, just where these two points connect. But like I said, I'm going to move it because I'm a big fan of trying to get away from tangents as much as possible. Mushu's neck just kind of comes straight down with a slight curve in it. And like I said, this is actually from a frame of a movie. So what's blocking Mushu in this picture is Mulan's helmet. So I'm just going to kind of rough in just this shape. I'm not going to do a lot of detail on it, but it shows that Mushu is behind something. And don't forget, you can kind of see a little bit of one of his back scales right there. All right, now Mushu's eyes are just big ovals. So we're just going to kind of rough those in, big ovals. And the same thing over here, but remember, it's going to be kind of like on the side of him. So he's kind of looking three-quarter view. All right, everybody, here's my rough end of Mushu. And now I'm going to do a little cleanup and straightening some of the lines and getting a little bit better. But I'll see y'all in just a few minutes. Okay, well, here's my cleaned up Mushu. Let's add a few more details. And now I'm gonna color him in and see what we get. So I'll see y'all again in a few seconds. Well, here's my Mushu. So let me sign it and let's see. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial on how to draw Mushu, and I'll see y'all again real soon.